ISIS Audiobooks presents an unabridged recording of The Bombmaker, written by Stephen Leather, read by Seán Barrett. It wasn't an especially big bomb, just a couple of pounds of Semtex, a detonator, a small digital clock, and a mercury tilt switch. The man carrying it wasn't overly afraid. He knew that the device had been tested a dozen times with a light bulb from a torch in place of the detonator. There was no way it could explode prematurely. The timer was set to activate its circuit in 30 minutes' time, and even then the device wouldn't explode until it was moved and the mercury tilt switch was tripped. A third circuit, separate from the first two, contained a photoelectric cell linked to a second detonator. The bomb maker had explained everything to him before closing the lid of the box and placing it in the blue holdall. The holdall that he was now carrying as casually as if it contained nothing more threatening than football kit. The man looked left and right, then squeezed through a gap in the railings and went down the embankment to the railway tracks. He walked along the sleepers, confident that there wouldn't be a train for at least an hour, by which time he'd be long gone. He took a quick look at his wristwatch. Plenty of time. Plenty of time to place the bomb at the designated location, then to get to the phone box and make the coded call. This wasn't a bomb designed to kill, it was meant to disrupt, to tie up the police, the army, and a bomb disposal team. That's not to say that it wasn't a serious bomb, but the men who turned up to deal with it would be experts. They'd x-ray it before touching it, and they'd see the circuits, and they'd blow it up with a controlled charge. In effect, they'd be blowing up the railway line themselves. Hours of disruption. Great publicity, and a reminder that they had the ability and the supplies to do harm. A nudge, that's all it was, though the man carrying the holdall knew that it was a nudge capable of leaving a crater 20 feet wide.